and welcome to This Dish of Road Warrior. I'm your host, Grant Robertson. Now, I have a family of six, so I'm always looking at the latest SUVs to make sure we can, of course, climb inside. Now, behind me is one of the best offerings on the road, the 2015 Hyundai Santa Fe. Now, there's two versions out there, the Sport or what you see here. Now, it's going to give you the best room inside, and the biggest part about that is it's not full size at all. The biggest internal debate I have is whether to go full-size SUV or something like this, a little bit more scaled down. Well, I've tested out the Lincoln Navigator, Ford Expedition, Chevy Tahoe, all as of late. And of course, I like that utilitarian side. Well, this offers just as much bang for your buck. Now, what you're going to find on this is obviously a scaled down exterior, a little bit more sleek versus the more robust designs you're going to find in the full size market. Even better, this offers just as much interior capabilities as the other models. When you look at the overall numbers, this vehicle easily fits into that mid-size class segment, around about 193 inches overall, wheelbase about 110. Now, if you're looking for off-road adventure, this does come in front-wheel drive, and more importantly, all-wheel drive version, which means basically getting those grips at all four corners. Lastly, its overall height, about 5.5 feet tall, and it's just over 6 feet wide. I've been talking about one small feature lately, and it has to do with the gas cap. Now, what you're gonna find a lot of vehicles that this is locked, related to the doors, kind of unlocks, press it, opens right up. Other vehicles like this one actually has more of a lever, which means you pull it from the inside and it's gonna pop open, giving you quicker access. Now, a lot of vehicles are going with the capless kind of system. This one actually has a full cap, just an extra process, but not that big a deal. This vehicle comes standard with 18-inch wheels or the 19-inch options you see here. Now, this particular model was front-wheel drive, but something that's going to help regardless is this lower cladding that we're seeing really across the industry that's going to help with a lot of scrapes and dings in this lower portion. A lot of them really rubber cladding it here, kind of adding a little bit more safety, less scratches, well, and even better when you go off-road. Swing around to the back, one of the most important areas on any SUV, well, it comes down to cargo, and sometimes with three rows, well, there's not a lot of offering. In my opinion, this is fairly decent numbers. Now, what's great on this limited model, the Ultimate, is really you got this power rear hatch making life so much simpler. Now, this also has a smart key system, keep it in your pocket, pretty much forget about it. Now, you're gonna go up to the old electronic release handle. It's gonna power out of the way. Now, once this is up, you're gonna find about 13.5 cubic feet of space behind this third row. Good numbers, really comparing to about the sedan market. Now, when you fold these rear seats down, it's going to triple the space to around about 40 cubic feet. Now, if you really need a lot of cargo options, well, simply fold all the back seat rows down. That's going to give you about 80 cubic feet, plenty of area to haul what you need. Under the rear cargo, you're gonna find a nice little niche for some added storage, even better. The car jack, if you need it, it's really right there front and center. No reason to try to find it. Now, even better is transforming this from people hauler to cargo, and they made it really easy. Now, one cumbersome aspect can be these headrests. Well, Hyundai figured that out. Simply pull on this handle, it's going to tuck these forward, then you can sling that out of the way. Now, these back seats are a 50-50 split, allowing you to transform it in numerous ways. To close the hatch, well, they put the button way up here, which the vertically challenged may complain about, instead of it being on the pillar. Now, when that closes, one thing to talk about is backup safety, and they have it built in here. The backup sensors, of course, ultrasonic feeling, and they give you those, you know, blind spot awareness, kind of that side traffic. Now, even better, there's always something you need to think about is a backup camera, and a lot of vehicles are announcing that they're gonna come standard, and Hyundai is one of those, built right here, give you a nice backup view. Being a big fan of the third row, well, that's one place to start. And first thing to look at is really the legroom numbers. Now, back here, you're looking at around about 31 inches. Now, what does that translate for a 6 foot tall person? Well, what you see, and what it means is your seating is really low to the floor, making your knees kind of positioned up high. Now, the bigger SUVs are really positioning those seats a little bit higher over that rear axle, giving a little bit more elevation, bringing your position a little bit more comfortable. But this isn't bad considering such the numbers of this vehicle. Now, another thing to think about is climate control. And what I like is the fact that they have them positioned here for the very rear occupant. Nothing worse than really having it hot back here and not being able to control it. Well, they have both the fan speed, the temperature select, even better where the mode is. Now, starting from the back of the car to the front, what we have here is the second row, and let's look at the legroom numbers, around about 41 inches, even better. That's the exact same numbers as the front, which means pretty much in the second and first row, equal comfort. Now, one great feature with that amount of legroom here, you can actually give some to the third row. And the way you do that is simply pull on the bar and slide it forward just a hair. Now, what does that mean? Well, it's gonna allow those back seat legs to stretch just a little bit more comfort. Probably averaging about 36, 37 inches here, maybe 34 back there. Now, what I like with this layout is you have a 2-2-2 design. The third row actually only handling two people. Total occupancy for this setup around about 6. What's great with the captain chairs? Individualized attention. Really starts with the armrest, swinging them into place. Really great access to the third row. Now, if you want to transform this again into cargo, you can do it right here from the second row. Simply pull on the handle down low here. That's going to tumble it forward. And again, with the amount of space you have in the second row, no headrest problems, no issues. This is just going to give you a nice added benefit when it comes to cargo. Now, we talked about ingress through the middle of this vehicle, but another thing you can do is really slide this seat out of the way, and then make it easy with the one handle here on the shoulder. You simply pull it, it's gonna tumble it just a hair forward, then you pull a little bit more, and it's gonna give you ingress right here. A little bit easier maybe for adults. For small children, I simply say go right through the middle and forget about it. Now, we talked about the individualized attention in the second row. One thing to note is there's a nice heated button right here for each captain's chairs. Now, another thing is really cooling down, and it all done with what I refer to as the limo shades. That's more in your luxury sedans. Here, it truly is a sunshade. And what that does is really extend out of the door itself, locks into place, and cuts down that natural heat that comes with the sun, giving you one added benefit for comfort back here. When you climb into the front, well, this is where it all comes together, giving you all the electronics. Of course, the best place to be is behind the steering wheel. And what I like is the added comfort you're going to find up here on this particular model, specifically the heating and cooling of seats. Now, we're in the summer months coming, and the cooling part really is going to help you cool down maybe even quicker than an AC unit. This particular model, being the Ultimate Limited, really is going to give you a lot of bells and whistles, and you're going to find a lot of them here at your fingertips on the steering wheel, really starting with the cruise control. And even better, the driving dynamics, really with the normal sport mode and comfort setting. This is going to give you a little bit more feel when it comes to the steering wheel. Now, when you scroll down, these are going to be the mode selects for the digital readout between the gauges, and of course your Bluetooth technology for your phone. And lastly is the entertainment controls here on the left. For the gauge cluster, you're going to find an analog display for the tach and speedometer with a little bit of a digital readout in between. That's going to give you a little bit of information for your entertainment, your compass, and different settings you can do on the vehicle. Now, one thing that was missing that I truly like is a digital readout for the speed. Other controls you'll find will be to the left of the steering wheel, one for the AC power way in the back, the heated steering wheel, and other various modes that you may need to access. Actually, you're going to find one of the biggest touchscreen systems on the market, really allowing you to access all the entertainment at your fingertips. Now, this is really great full screen, and you can go through the various selection modes simply by using the buttons down below. Now, we did use the Bluetooth connectivity, connecting the phone, streaming the music, and of course, connecting to calls when we needed. For the climate control, they pretty much keep it real simple. Better yet, they make a huge oversized knob for the fan, one of the biggest features you'll want to reach for versus any other functions. Now, there is dual climate control up front, really dial in specific setting. And even better, they pretty much minimize the button. The only other important one really is the mode select, selecting where the air flows. Way down low in the dash, kind of in a little niche, you're going to find dual outlets for power, USB connection, and auxiliary jack. And there's a nice place to store your devices just below. Regardless of trim package, there's only one engine choice, and a decent one at that. That's a 3.3 liter V6, going to deliver around about 290 horses and 252 foot-pounds of torque. Now, again, you can equip that to a front-wheel drive or all-wheel drive model. I prefer the latter, especially in a slippery situations. That does it for this edition of Road Warrior, and a test drive behind the wheel of the 2015 Hyundai Santa Fe. Again, the bigger sibling to the Santa Fe Sport. Now, what it delivers is the three rows of comfort, but in a downsized approach. Again, we don't always need full-size offerings in those full-size sport utilities, but this still delivers decent cargo, decent occupancy, and pretty good pep under the hood. Now, as always, like, thank you for watching this edition of Road Warrior. Keep both hands on the wheel and eyes straight ahead.